And welcome to yet another amazing class with us Byju's. I'm Aishwarya, and in this video, we are going to be discussing about something very exciting and interesting. That is the ABO blood grouping system. So in this video, we will learn about what is the ABO system, how it came to be and who discovered it, and what is the basis of this system of being formed and why it is important for us to know about it. But before I get started with today's class, if this is the first time that you are visiting our channel and if this is the first video that you are coming across, I would like you to say welcome to our small little family. Now, our family, of course, has been growing and we would want you to be a part of it. So please do hit the subscribe button. And in this channel, we have a lot of exciting things going on at all times. So I'm just going to take 2 minutes of your time to quickly take you through it. I'm sure that you would have watched these wonderful videos about the Akash National Talent Hunt exam. And I'm sure at some point you must be wondering, right? How does it really matter if I give this exam or no? What is the whole basis and point of it? Now, the thing is, whatever you aspire to be, whether it is a scientist, a doctor, an engineer, or a lawyer, at some point in life in the future, you might have to give a competitive exam. And at that point, it may get very overwhelming because you don't know what it is to give a competitive exam. That is why the ANTHE that is there is here for you. It's a simple talent hunt exam and it's absolutely free. You do not need to pay anything. And the link is there in the description box, so you can definitely check it out. And on giving ANTHE, you will understand what it is to prepare for an exam, what kind of strategy you need to apply, so that the next time when you're giving an exam, you will be well prepared. And there's a lot of things which are there up for grabs as well. You have All India rank that you can secure, up to win up to 100% scholarship, cash rewards, and a few lucky students will win an all expense paid trip to NASA. So as you can see, there's a lot that you will gain on just giving ANTHE, so do register now. The exam is scheduled to happen in November. Now, an ongoing series in our channel is the Mission Midterms. And we know that this series is exclusively there for 45 days, where we will help you ace your midterm exams. And we have a variety of sessions that are there. One-shot sessions, exam focus sessions, doubt solving, strategy sessions, mock tests, and so much more. And in turn, all we are asking is that you stay subscribed to our channel. Yes, that's all that we are requesting. So hit the subscribe button and the bell icon. And last but never the least, we have the Byju's mini learning program, which is back with a new interesting code that is the YT First code, where the first 1,000 users every week can avail it for free. And in the mini learning program, you will have access to the two teacher advantage. You will be able to solve your doubts live and you will have interaction with your teachers, right? And of course, you will have post-class assessments as well. So now that I have told you what all you can get on our platform, all you need to do is to hit that subscribe button. And without wasting any more time, we are going to get started with today's class that is on the ABO blood grouping system. Now, there will be times where medical professionals will be faced circumstances where maybe the patient is facing some illness, maybe some disorder, or has encountered a serious injury. Now, in such cases, we see that it may lead to massive loss of blood from the body. Now, when there's massive loss of blood from the body, what they immediately resort to is, of course, to provide blood supplementally or to supplement the body with blood. And this process of providing blood externally and supplementing it is what we call as blood transfusion. Now, this, of course, sounds like a very simple process, but it is not. Because there are a lot of things. Before providing the blood to the patient, they need to do a lot of tests. This blood that they are providing and the patient's blood should match. Now you must be thinking, right? Ma'am, blood is blood. How does it matter? Both are red in color. We can do it. As a matter of fact, no. There's a lot of tests that are done in order to make sure that they match and it is the right kind of blood. And we see that this person who is receiving the blood is who we call as a recipient. And of course, this blood also would have come from somebody, right? It's not that they manufactured any blood. It has come from an individual who has donated his or her blood. And we call this as the donor blood. So very important thing to understand is that the donor and the recipient must match, right? And they do a lot of tests to make sure that they match. But what is the basis of them matching this blood? That is where the concept of the ABO blood grouping system comes into the picture. Now, in the ABO blood grouping system, we know that there are four blood types. We have blood group A, blood group B, blood group AB, and blood group O. And this ABO system was discovered in the year 1900 by Karl Landsteiner. And he was awarded the Nobel Prize for the same. Because you see, over time, this discovery revolutionized the concept of blood transfusion, and it made sure that people did a lot of testing before actually transfusing blood. Now, before I get to understanding what is so important about the ABO blood grouping system, there are two terminologies that you must get familiar with, because I will be using them constantly throughout today's video. That is an antigen and an antibody. Now you see, an antigen can be simply defined as a substance which can induce an immune response or trigger an immune reaction. Which means that an antigen, when it is there in the body, can trigger our immune cells, right? And in response to that antigen is what is produced is an antibody. So antibodies are nothing but substances which are produced in response to an antigen. And they are nothing but proteins which are produced, right? So they are Y-shaped proteins. Now, a very important thing here is that antibodies which are produced in the body are highly specific to the antigen, right? So I'm specifying this. They are highly specific to the antigen, which means that if thousands of antigens enter into the body, 1,000 varieties of antibodies will be produced so that they are highly specific. And that's how they are effective in our body as well. Now, what's interesting here, or why we need to know about antigen and antibody, is simply because in our RBCs, right, we see that there are various surface proteins that act as surface antigens. So in the RBCs, right, so if you notice here, in the RBCs on the surface, it was noticed that there were certain proteins which we call as antigens. And broadly, there were two kinds of antigens. So we had the A antigen and the B antigen. And based on what kind of antigen is present is how we have decided the four blood grouping systems. So let's take an example of A blood group. We see that in A blood group, we have antigen A, which is present on the surface of the RBC. But what was interesting is that in the plasma of the blood, right? So we know that plasma is nothing but the fluid part that is there in the blood. In the fluid part, there were antibodies which were produced, right? And antibodies are produced in response to the antigen. But interestingly, it was not antibody A, but rather it was antibody E, B, which we call as anti-B. And we see that antibody B is not specific to antigen A. And there'll be no reaction that occurs between this antigen A and antibody, and that's how it is able to go. But then what if in a person who has this antigen A on the surface of the RBC, had antibody A, what would happen then? Well, you see, anti-A is highly specific to antigen A, right? Which means that if antibody A was present in the blood, it will start to clump up around this antigen. And this clumping reaction that is taking place, I'm explaining this in very, very simple terminologies, right? So when they start to clump up around, we call this as agglutination. And when agglutination takes place, we see that this is how actually antibodies get rid of pathogens out of the body, right? But now imagine if it is happening to our own RBCs. Then we see that eventually this could be fatal, which is why we see that in a person who has blood group A, that means antigen A on the surface, will have antibody B on in its plasma, right? This is not feasible. So similarly, in this concept, if we move on to the second blood type, that is blood group B, right? We see that the antigen that is present on the surface is antigen B. And in the plasma, we will not find antibody B, but we will find anti-A, right? So this is what we will find in the plasma. So this is about the second blood group. Now, third blood group that we have is AB, right? Now, what would we find in AB blood group? Now, as the name suggests, it is A and B. That means that both antigen A as well as antigen B will be present. But the thing here is that there will be no antibodies that were going to be present in the plasma. Because we know that if any kind of antibody is there, it will come and it will start doing the agglutination reaction. So we have looked at A, which has antigen A, right? B, which has antigen B, AB, where both the antigens are there. Then what about O? What is there in O blood group? Now in O blood group, we observe that there is no antigen present on the surface of the RBC. But in the plasma, we will find both the antibodies which will be present. So this is the concept that is there behind the blood grouping system, the A, B, AB and O. But how are we going to apply this concept in blood transfusion, right? How do we decide who is getting which blood? Now it is very simple that if a person has A blood group, he can receive blood from an individual who has A blood group, right? So this is common. So if a person has B blood group, he will get from B. If a person has AB, then he will get it from a person who has AB, O, and so on. This is direct transfusion of the same kind of blood group is, of course, what we know is going to happen. But interestingly, we also know, so I'm just going to write it down. So we have O, A, AB, and B, right? Now we know that the antigens that are present, so I'm going to write all the antibodies that are there. So we know that the antibody here is anti-B, right? And we know that here what we have is anti-A. And here we know that both anti-A and anti-B will be present. Now the thing here is that a person who has AB blood group can get, they can receive blood from a person who has A, can get blood who has a person who has B, right? And can get blood from a person who has O. But now you must be telling, right, ma'am, here there is no antigens. I mean, there are no antibodies in the plasma. But you are telling me that A, B, O all can donate blood. That is because of the antigens, right? So what we need to focus more on is not the antibodies, but the kind of antigen. Because antigens are what will trigger a immune response in the body. So the antigens must match, right? So all these antigens that are there should be matching. So here antigen A is there, here antigen B is here, here both antigen A and B are there. The other whatever proteins that are there, they will, so even if antibodies are present, they will be removed out by the body. See, if anti-A is there and it goes to a person who has AB, this anti-BA that is there will get recognized as foreign and they will remove it. That is still okay. But the antigens must match. That is very, very important to understand. Which is why similarly, we see that since there's no antigen present on O, right? So here we see that there is no antigen. Which is why it is still okay if we give or donate blood. A person with O blood group can donate. He can even donate to a person with A. He can also donate to a person with B. So in this case, a person with O blood group is considered to be a universal donor. While a person with AB, since he's receiving blood from everybody else, is considered to be a universal recipient. Now, I understand at one go this can be slightly tricky, which is why we have a question here for you that you can pause this video and solve by yourself, right? Or you can take a screenshot and do it by yourself also. I would completely recommend it. But I am going to quickly solve it with you. So we have a person who has blood group A. Let's have a look at the first one. And which antigen does he have? He has antigen A on the surface. And we know that the donor blood, he can get it from a person who already has A, or he can get it from someone who has O. So the plasma, or the antibody that we will find on the plasma is anti-B, right? The complementary antibody we will find. Similarly, we see that a person with blood group B has anti-A antibody in the plasma, which means that the antigen in the RBC will be antigen B. And we know that O is the universal donor here, which means he or she will get blood from O and of course from B, right? Which means an individual who has B. Now, next up, we see that antigens that are present on the RBC is, of course, we see that it is A and B, which means blood group here is AB. And we see that there is no antibodies that will be present on the plasma. And this can get blood from A, from B, and from O. It is a universal recipient. Now, we know that O has no antigens but has both anti-A and anti-B, right? And in this case, we see that O will only be able to get blood from an individual who is having O blood group, right? So I did not discuss this point earlier, but now that we have it here, let's quickly discuss that. We know that it's an universal donor. But on the other hand, it will not be able to receive blood from any other blood group because all of them will have antigens, right? So that is important to understand. So this, of course, is the answer here. Now, before we wind up, we know that there's A, B, A, B, and O. But we also see that when we write it as A, B positive or O positive, yes? And I'm sure that in your school reports or even your birth certificate, you will be able to see things like this. So what does this term positive sign stand for? Now, positive here is with reference to a factor that is there in the blood that is there, which is the rhesus factor, right? So or the Rh factor or the rhesus factor. Now, this was identified in rhesus monkey, hence the name, and in around 1940, and Alexander Wiener had a very important role to play in this discovery. Now, here, this rhesus factor is again an antigen, an Rh antigen that is present on the surface of the RBC. Now, if this antigen, or what popularly is also known as antigen D, if the Rh antigen is present, as you can see, on the surface, then we say that it is positive. While if it is not there, we say that it is negative. And that is how we have the A positive, B positive, AB positive, O positive, right? And so on, A negative, B negative blood groups. So with this, if you see, we've had an understanding into what is blood grouping, how it has come about, how we use it in blood transfusion, right? And of course, for blood transfusion, there are thorough checks, right? They do thorough checks, make sure that there is no agglutination taking place. Only then will they be, you know, transfusing the blood. So now, of course, we will be sharing this session PDF with all of you in our Telegram community. So if you're still not part of it, do join our very own family, because in our Telegram community, we have a lot of exciting things going on for you. So please do join our Telegram channel. And you know that no matter what, we've got you covered, right? And you know that. So if you like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to our channel and hit that like button. Hoping to see you all very soon again. Bye-bye and have a nice day.